After looking at these photos, I bet you'd be surprised if I told you that this cute and adorable little orange SCP subject is actually the son of the Scarlet King SCP-001 himself. But I'll get more details on that topic later. Greetings, my like-minded comrades. As you already know, I've dedicated my time and effort into exposing all subjects that the SCP Foundation has kept hidden from us. And as such, I have studied and understood quite a number of SCP subjects, but this particular subject, known as SCP-999 or simply the Tickle Monster, is one of the few whose true potential cannot fully be explained. The subject belongs to the safe class and is currently held in containment at the SCP Foundation. The special containment protocols for SCP-999 is in a rather unusual manner. The subject is free to roam the SCP facility whenever it wants, but it must be returned to its holding cell, either to sleep between the time of 8 to 9 p.m. or in case of a containment breach by another SCP subject or even a lockdown. This protocol must be carried out to ensure SCP-999's safety. Furthermore, the subject is not allowed to be outside its containment at nighttime or outside the Foundation grounds at any time. The subject's containment must be kept clean at all times, and its food must be replaced twice daily. SCP personnel are also allowed to make contact with SCP-999 whenever they are on a break or just passing by. Personnel are also advised to play with the Tickle Monster when it looks bored and even talk with it in a calm and non-threatening tone. If I didn't know any better, I'd assume that SCP-999 is a mere pet for the Foundation, due to its physical, adorable appearance and its behavior. But I can very much tell you that such a thought is far beyond the case. Speaking of appearance, SCP-999 appears to be quite a large gelatinous, amorphous entity, which looks like a transparent slime. Its last recorded weight was approximately 54 kilograms or 120 pounds, which in itself is ideal for a creature with a consistency similar to peanut butter. The subject can also change its shape at will because of its size and malleable body structure. When at rest, SCP-999 takes the form of a rounded and somewhat oblate dome, which measures thinly around 2 meters wide and 1 meter high. The monster's surface is made up of a very thin, transparent, and highly elastic membrane, which looks very similar to the cell membrane of an animal, and it was measured to be about 0.5 centimeters thick. This elastic nature allows the subject to flatten parts of its body up to 2 centimeters thin in order to get through obstacles easily. Its surface is also hydrophobic in nature. However, the Tickle Monster can absorb liquids whenever it pleases. It can also ingest organic materials with ease. But why do they call it the Tickle Monster? Well, as the name implies, it likes to tickle whoever it's playing with. Basically, when someone approaches the subject, it tends to leap towards that person, enveloping them with its pseudopods in what looks like a hug, while at the same time nuzzling the person's face with the third pseudopod, during which the creature emits a high-pitched gurgling and cooing noise, at least until it's done playing with the person. If you thought this creature couldn't get any more weird, well, you're wrong. Because after multiple series of tests done by multiple SCP Class 1 personnel, the Foundation also discovered that the Tickle Monster emits a pleasing odor which could differ in smell depending on whomever it is interacting with. Some of the recorded scents include fresh laundry, bacon, chocolate, roses, and Play-Doh. I can't say for sure if the creature just randomly creates these scents. It could be that the creature, when interacting with a person, gives off a scent that is synonymous or somewhat important to that particular person. Or it could just be giving away scents of things it has previously eaten. Whichever the case may be, this ability still remains a mystery, even to the SCP Foundation. Moving on, after a further inspection and a somewhat first-hand interview with personnel who have come in direct contact with SCP-999, my informant was able to give me a well-detailed profile on the Tickle Monster's main ability. From this data, it would appear that even so much as a simple touch on the surface of SCP-999's body can cause an immediate mild euphoria in the person, and this euphoria gradually intensifies the longer the person is exposed to the Tickle Monster. It even continues for a while, even after the person person has been separated from the subject. When in contact with a person, the subject tends to engage in tickle fights, although, because of its body and abilities, I believe we can already tell that the Tickle Monster is an undisputed champion in tickle fights. Sometimes a person can get so lost in their laughter that they forget to tell the Tickle Monster to stop, in which all cases, leads to some serious injuries. While on some occasions the person does tell the monster to stop, although the subject doesn't always tend to completely listen with this request, which is in the end also which leads to injuries of such personnels involved. Even after there have been multiple records of injuries, it is however certain that SCP-999 never intentionally made an attempt to hurt anyone, and in the event that someone gets hurt while in a tickle fight with it, the subject will immediately back away from the person and contract itself into what looks like a quivering mold while gurgling in a manner similar to that of a whimpering dog, which could be an indication that the creature is trying to apologize for hurting the person. Although the creature tends to interact with just about anybody or creature, it does have a special preference for humans, most especially people who are suffering from depression or PTSD, all of which, after coming in contact with the subject, reported having a more positive mindset on life in general. Reports also have it that the SCP Foundation is currently working alongside various pharmaceutical companies to create antidepressants from the slime of SCP-999. In addition to its very playful nature, SCP-999 looks like it is in love with all the animals, most especially humans. Hence, it has refused to eat any kind of meat, and it even risks its own life to save others. The Foundation couldn't estimate the limit it was willing to go in order to save a person's life, so they placed the subject and a Class 1 personnel in a holding cell, while a guard attempted to shot the personnel in front of SCP-999. The result was a moment kind of like in a movie, but this time, it was the Tickle Monster diving in front of the person to try and save his life. Sure, the subject may look dumb. It does, however, seem to understand human speech and some modern technology, which is how it knew what a gun was. When it comes to feeding, the subject consumes its food the same way an amoeba does. It seems to feed only on sweets and candies, but in general it prefers M&Ms, wafers, and Necco. However, caffeinated drinks of any kind must not be given to the subject. This was a law passed by the Foundation called Addendum SCP-999-A, which was basically a reminder to all SCP staffs not to feed the Tickle Monster with any caffeinated drink. It also went further, saying that an SCP staff had previously gave the subject a can of cola along with his usual breakfast, and the cola made it roll up into a ball and bounce off the walls of its container for at least an hour before entering a queasy state and refusing to eat for the rest of the day. But luckily for the Foundation, the subject was able to recover. However, the staff in question has been reprimanded. After nearly a year in the Foundation's custody, Dr. Shemi carried out a more advanced experiment with SCP-999. This time, he wanted to see if the creature could calm the omnicide rage of another SCP subject called SCP-682, or the Heart to Destroy Reptile. In this case, the Tickle Monster was released into the cell of SCP-682, and after brief excited jumps and high-pitched squeal, the Tickle Monster was eventually crushed by an unimpressed and still angry SCP-682. In that moment, Dr. Shemi and the other observers were about to stop the experiment to confirm if SCP-999 was alright, but before they could do that, SCP-682 began talking. This time, it started making some strange sounds, which could be similar to a light chuckle, and it even went on to say, "I feel good." After a short period of time, SCP-999 regained its form back from enveloping itself around SCP-682. The process continued for almost 2 hours, all the while the Heart to Destroy Reptile couldn't stop laughing and saying, "I feel so happy." After which, SCP-682 passed out from exhaustion while still maintaining what looked like a smile on its face. After 15 minutes with no activity inside the the containment cell, two Class D personnel were sent inside to retrieve SCP-999. But in the process of removing the Tickle Monster, SCP-682 immediately wakes and releases an unknown wave of energy from its body while still laughing. And to Dr. Shemi's surprise, everyone within the range of the unknown wave immediately collapsed into an uncontrollable fit of laughter, which unfortunately for them was the last laugh they ever had, because SCP-682 pounced on the two Class D personnel and killed them immediately. However, after killing several SCP employees, the Tickle Monster has still shown no fear towards the hard-to-destroy reptile. As a matter of fact, it still makes gestures towards the creature, which implies that it wants to play with the SCP-682 over and over again. But on the other hand, the hard-to-destroy reptile has made it known to the Foundation that it never wants to see SCP-999 again, sang in its words. That feculent little can and die. Dr. Shemi even considered the test one of the funniest moments he has ever seen within the SCP Foundation, even though the experiment was a failure. Although the Tickle Monster appears to be a cute and cuddly little thing, but that may not be the case when it is fully grown. Which brings us back to why I called it the son of the Scarlet King earlier. According to records, the Tickle Monster is the offspring of both the Scarlet King and the SCP-2327, a young girl, pure of heart, whose offsprings are considered to be the heroes and saviors of man compared to her other sisters. The Foundation tried to prevent her from giving birth to SCP-999 for over 2 years because they believed that her offspring would be the final piece that the Scarlet King needed to bind himself to our reality. Using a process called exemptation, the Foundation prevented her from conceiving for a period of 2 years before she eventually was allowed to give birth to SCP-999, which at the time came as a shock to everyone present. Not only did the Foundation keep the true source of the Tickle Monster a secret from a lot of its members, they also fed them the false narrative that SCP-2327 was still under the effects of the exemptation. But I can't blame them for this decision making. I mean, would you be willing to tell your members that the creature they see on a daily basis is the son of the devil? Well, I guess they wouldn't either. There is also the fact that the tale considers a child born of the seventh daughter, which in this case is SCP-2327, would be the one to take out the Scarlet King. I can't say for sure if this is possible, but I can't dismiss the possibility either. The results of the interaction between SCP-682 and 999 concludes that even at a young age, the Tickle Monster can manipulate the behavior of a rage-induced monster. Although my advice for the SCP Foundation would be to restrict the creature's freedom the older it gets, because with age comes wisdom, and if that creature gets the wrong idea about humanity, the results may be catastrophic. But for now, I'll have to keep looking into its data, and I'll let you guys know if I find anything useful. So, what do you think? Is the Tickle Monster humanity's best hope against the Scarlet King? Or is it just an evil entity hidden in the body of an adorable creature? Share your thoughts in the comment section below. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you wish to follow me on my hindsight into the SCP subjects.